Hey everybody, welcome to another Prison Break Review Breakdown with me and good old King Kansas. How you doing?
Fabulous, Scotty. You know, I can't wait to talk about this episode of Prison Break, buddy. What's this, episode number seven?
Seven.
Well, I can't wait. Scotty?
We still got two more episodes.
I can't wait. The next one looks even better, the little preview we've seen. But for now, we're discussing this episode. Scotty?
Yes.
Take it away, buddy. You're the genius.
All right. So the episode starts off in Brooklyn, New York?
Brooklyn, yeah. Somewhere in New York.
So little Mike is doing his homework. Sarah and her husband are there. Mm-hmm. And I believe she gets a phone call.
She gets a phone call from Link.
From Link, and Link is like, we found him. Mm-hmm. He's alive, but he's been poisoned.
Yep.
And we need you here, or something yeah, along those lines.
We need you to meet in Greece.
In Greece. So then her husband, Jacob, now his name is Jacob.
Yep. Scumbag.
The biggest scumbag in the world. Big time. He's like, is everything okay? And mm-hmm. Sarah, being a stupid idiot, thinking that everything is done and she can trust him, says, Michael's poisoned and
he's alive. He's poisoned and she needs to go there.
Yeah, and he didn't like that too much because mm-hmm. we all know he's Poseidon.
Yes.
So then she gets on a taxi.
Yep.
Goes to the airport.
Exactly.
And then flies to Greece.
Yep.
Now we're going to go back to the Yemen,
yes.
place. Michael is there poisoned. They're yep. getting off a boat or some sort of
to thing. To go to Crete, Greece, where they're yep. going to meet up with Sarah.
Yep. So there's some conflict or dialogue exchanged with the Asian guy and the Australian.
Yes. They left him behind because he wanted to stay home and free before they got on the boat. And then what Sky's referring to, the Australian guy, which I think he calls him... what is it? I want to call him Wink.
Wink?
Because Michael's basically assistant or whatever, right? Mm-hmm. So him and Link have a thing saying, oh, you know, like he apologizes, Scotty, for accusing Link for not doing everything to save Michael and all that. So they kind of sell it over a couple of beers.
Yeah.
Everything is good. And then from there, Scotty?
From there, the world ends.
Not quite. This is when Sarah ends up arriving there.
Yeah.
She deals with Michael, you can tell.
Yeah, because when she saw Michael for the first time, she's like, oh my God, he's alive. She didn't say that, but she was shocked to see him because
yes.
he's been supposedly dead for 7 years.
Exactly.
And she comes, mm-hmm. she gets everything ready.
Out of her medical kit.
Yeah, to do the blood transfusion. Mm-hmm. So she gave her own blood to help.
She's O negative, Scotty?
O negative, so that's the most
universal
demanded blood.
Whatever, yeah. It goes with every kind of type, which is kind of cool that she's all negative all of a sudden.
Yeah. yeah. Mm-hmm. Anyway, so she does the transfusion.
Yep.
She ends up being healed from it. Mm-hmm. And Michael's like, do you have a picture of my son or whatever he said?
Exactly, on the phone.
So he got the phone.
Yep.
He saw the picture of Mike. Yep. They were talking a little bit and then he swiped to the next photo. And guess who he saw? The scumbag with Sarah. I think Mike was in that picture.
All three of them.
And he's like... He looks at it. Sarah's like, what's wrong? He gets up. When he gets up from his
little
injury, you know it's big. And she's like, what's wrong? He's like, your husband. That's Jacob. He's like, yeah, that's Poseidon. Confirmed all our speculation.
Scotty and I are geniuses, like I told you guys.
Oh, yeah.
Episode number 3, Scotty, I think we mentioned it.
Yeah.
For our reviews here. Mm-hmm.
Because ever since Theodore Bagwell took that picture of them, all
we
three of them.
We knew what was going on. Exactly.
We knew it was him. And boy, when Sarah told him that he was alive, he was pissed.
And she felt so stupid that she was saying that she fell for it, his mm-hmm. act and everything, mm-hmm. which we didn't think originally she fell for it. I think she was just faking it, but I guess not.
Yeah, she fell for it because she's a stupid loser.
That's right. and then from there, Scotty, what happens? What do they decide they're going to do?
So they're going to try to leave, right?
Sarah leaves to go home, but she has to put up an act.
Yeah, put up a mask, as Michael says.
Yes.
Pretend like you don't know what's going on.
Exactly.
So then she ends up going back to the States. But before she comes back, the little Mike was playing with his little helicopter.
Yes, in the backyard.
So the helicopter kind of crashes.
Yes.
So he goes into the woods. Mm-hmm. Before he grabs it, someone kidnaps him.
Yes, and that's when we find out that he got taken to his parents' house before her girlfriend ends up picking him up after yep. later on.
For sleepover.
So Scotty?
Yep, so she ends up coming home, right?
Yes, that's when Poseidon puts trackers on her that knows that she's coming back through the airport and mm-hmm. to kind of keep an eye on Michael Schofield and the team because there's something fishy there, and that's when?
That's when she comes home. Mm-hmm. She's like, oh, where's Mike?
Exactly.
And he's like, well, Mike's at his friend's house. Oh, okay, gonna...
Yes, it's his friend's house.
No, his friend's house.
Sorry, Scotty.
She's gonna go shower or clean and whatever. Yeah. So she goes upstairs, she turns on the tap, mm-hmm. just to make the illusion that she's doing something.
To make the phone call to her friend.
To her friend, and yeah, can you take Mike to whatever?
Your house.
To your house. This was at night, though.
Yes.
So as they were going, the husband kind of knew what was going on.
Oh, he's not stupid, trust me. He's not Poseidon for no reason. He's Mr. Genius,
so
right?
So she comes down.
Yep.
She's trying to find something that's hidden.
That's right.
But he pops out of nowhere.
Mm-hmm.
And he's like, well, you don't trust me.
Exactly.
I thought we had trust, blah, 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 blah. Stupid con talk they do.
Mm-hmm.
So then he leaves.
Yep.
She opens up one of the, well, takes the frames out.
Exactly.
Takes a gun. A pistol. Was it a pistol?
It's a gun.
Some sort of gun.
She had a secret stash with bullets in her gun that she put in the wall. Like you were talking about, Scotty.
Fully loaded.
I would have used that damn thing, man. And she didn't.
Yeah. And then I think Jacob goes to his office or something like that.
Yes, and he's going to make a phone call because he's calling the agents to kind of look out for Michael Schofield.
For Michael Schofield, yep.
So then before we continue this part, Scotty, talk about the boat because they needed to get out of Greece mm-hmm. to head to the United States. So who did they meet up with, Scotty?
So before they went on the boat,
yes.
Lincoln gave a call to one of his buddies.
Because they were looking for three options, it was, and that was the third option for them, apparently.
And I was complaining, where was Sucre?
And Scotty got his wish, guys.
Sucre showed up. Sucre was on a boat.
Yeah.
He kind of stashed his dolls.
Yeah, unique dolls. Let's just say that, which, kind of creeped everybody out. They kind of had a good laugh with the rest of the team.
I was sitting with my mom watching, and they're like, are those real girls? But they weren't moving, so we knew they were dolls.
I want to say the word, like, fetish dolls. I'm just going to say that.
Yeah.
I think you guys can use your imagination. We're trying to keep this clean, right, Scotty?
Yeah, I'll use the proper term for that later on.
Sure, I don't have time to go to church, Scotty, so that's why I didn't want to say what they really are.
So they want to get on the boat.
Yep.
But Sucre is like, there's like $15K you have to pay.
50.
50K that you have to pay to get on the boat.
Mm-hmm.
But Sarah, we totally skipped that. Sarah gave Michael the ring, her grandmother's ring.
Yes.
Before she left.
Mm-hmm.
So she had that.
That's right.
They had that as a deposit.
So that was their payment, right?
Yeah. So then they get on the boat.
Mm-hmm. What's the captain say, Scotty?
Captain say, where's my money?
He wanted cash. He didn't want a damn ring. He wanted money.
He wanted
the
cash.
So he knew he was a scumbag.
Yeah, so he knew he was hiding something on
the
ship.
Yeah, he was up to something with his ship. Because for Sucre to be involved, Scotty, there had to be some sort of smuggling. I think that was going on. Yeah,
so Michael gave the ring. Michael's like, this is a 15 carat or something like that.
It's 50K, but he goes that it's been appraised for 100-something thousand.
Yeah.
So you got more than enough.
Mm-hmm. So you got 50 more on top.
Trade
the ring. Whatever.
So everything looks okay, Scotty? We thinking that, you know what? They're enjoying themselves. Michael's resting to go back. And
so then they were going around the ship to find their, like, settled place.
Yes.
Sucre shows his bright idea.
Mm-hmm.
Sex dolls, as the Australian guy says. What do you have? That's sex dolls?
I said fetish, but it's okay. Scotty said, then I'm cool.
Yeah, well,
we're good.
That's the guy.
That's what they are.
That's what they.
That's what they are. They were live, like very real. Whatever the crap, and the team was like laughing. Like, are you serious? This is what you're doing?
But
he asked them in on it, right?
Yeah.
He wanted a part of it because that's what he's into. He's doing.
Yeah.
That.
So Sucre was like, well, they're not that kind of dolls, and Lincoln.
Bull crap.
And then the Australian guy's like, no, they're sex dolls.
Yes. Yeah, it was funny.
It was really funny.
Yeah.
So then they go to like their little cabin room.
Yep.
And they're having a beer.
Sucre's little quarters, I want to say, that they're drinking and, you know, reminiscing.
They're having a beer and all that. And then the two agents met up with the Asian guy.
That's right.
And the Asian guy's
in
like,
Portland.
Yeah, he's like, the Asian guy's like, oh, why are you doing this, blah, blah, blah,
and
blah.
Why are you trying to catch this guy? What are you doing?
Yeah.
And
one of the agents just, poof.
Done.
Put the bullet right in his forehead.
That's right.
Killed him.
Problem solved, right, Scotty?
Yeah. And then Jacob calls somebody.
But we find out it's someone on the ship.
On the ship, yeah. So
and what is it, Scotty? I guess what comes through that?
It came through the printer.
Yep. Like a printer. A wanted poster of?
Of Michael Schofield, but it said he has an other name.
Keneal Otis or whatever the hell his name is. I can't even pronounce the name. Yep. But it's Schofield, basically.
Because Jacob, when he was talking to Sarah, he set up that murder.
Yes, he did.
The earlier episode set up Michael.
That's right.
So he grabbed the video, he edited the video.
Yeah, to make it look. Episode one is when we see Michael drag that body, but then Michael didn't know he's just there to help him.
Yeah,
because, and that's when he filmed to frame him so he can get him to do whatever the hell
so
he wanted.
Yeah, so he took the footage, he edited it the way he wanted to look like Michael was the bad one.
Exactly.
So like basically
to,
what
to
they
forced his hand, yeah, basically.
Basically what they did with Lincoln in the first season.
Yes. They did it on Michael this time.
So yeah, so then that's that.
So we go back on the boat. The guy goes, "Hey, listen, I'm gonna call, I guess, the agents," because it was the two agents that were kind of contacting him, Scott.
Yeah, and then they got the US Marine involved.
The Navy SEALs, baby.
Yep, they came onto the ship. But Sucre had a plan.
That's right. So when they heard the commotion outside.
Yep. So Sucre told them to tie him up and beat him up.
Yep.
And guess they were hiding anything under the bed.
Yeah, it was underneath a bed or a bench that all of them could fit there. Because we thought they went out the window, right, Scotty?
Yeah.
Which I thought, but I go, no, something too simple about that.
Yeah, because the window was open and looked like something was thrown out.
Exactly.
To give the illusion that they
jumped out.
They came
and they
out.
They tied
of the
him up, right?
Yep. So then the Marines came in.
Mm-hmm.
Only found him. They took his face thing off. He's like, "Oh man, they beat me up. I didn't know they were doing this, blah blah blah."
Yep.
Smart. Smart guy.
Been in jail for a while. They know how to think on their feet, guys.
Yep. So then they get taken back to the
captain's quarters,
and they're looking around the ship.
Yep, they were questioning him, right, Scotty?
Yep. And then Sucre is like to the captain, "Why are you hiding your smuggling or whatever he was smuggling?"
Yeah.
And then the one of the guards like just watching.
Yep.
And then he's trying to page his other teammates, but they weren't listening.
Mm-hmm.
And then he went to go find it because he's smuggling something that he's not supposed to.
Exactly. And the captain was smuggling too.
Yeah. So they were both smuggling things.
Because he had a secret storage place that he was smuggling. We know what they were. They were bang, bang.
Yeah.
Guns and ammunition. Right, Scott?
Mm-hmm. Big time. Lots of them. Mm-hmm. So then the SEALs wanted to go search the boat. They couldn't find them.
Yeah, because that provided that perfect distraction, right, Scotty? So they can sneak out, and they got kind of locked up in the... It looked like the furnace room?
Yeah.
Was it the furnace room?
It looked like it, because the tear gas and all that.
Yeah, that's when they set off tear gases to go up into the cabins or something. I don't know if they were planning on that.
They went outside of the ship.
There you go.
And Jacob ordered an airstrike on the boat. So everybody jumped.
Hold on. Before you go there, Scotty, go back to Sarah with them with the final...
Right. So Sarah confronts Jacob.
Mm-hmm.
Puts a gun towards his head, and Jacob is like, "What are you doing?"
Exactly.
It's like, "Well, you've been lying to me," mm-hmm. blah, blah, blah. And Sarah's like, "Your plan didn't work."
Exactly.
And she's like, "We knew what you were doing."
And then, Scotty, what did come out of Jacob's mouth?
What came out of his mouth?
When he said to Sarah that if you better go according to plan or...
Yeah, you better put your gun down or Mike and her friend are going to get the bullet.
Yeah, her son and their friend, because he kind of caught on that she had called to go and basically take the kid from harm's way because he was using the kid as like blackmail, I want to call
bait.
It, you know, kind of thing.
Bait.
Like bait.
So then she puts it down and then they... talk after that. I don't know what they did.
Yeah, they kind of went from there, guys. She kind of basically said, "You better do what I say, or Michael, even Schofield's gonna die or whatever." But in the meantime, he also made a phone call before the whole confrontation to the agents who ordered
the airstrike.
Now,
so now they all the soldiers were leaving.
The Navy SEAL, they kind of like booked it for some reason, and
Michael,
the captain's wondering what
Michael
the hell.
Noticed. Like, whoa,
yeah, what's
they're
going on?
They're leaving. So then they left. They all jumped.
Mm-hmm.
First, they threw a raft to float. I think the captain died though.
The captain was on the ship, Scotty. Michael and the guys looked outside and seen all of a sudden like some sort of missile headed towards them, and that's when Michael grabbed the raft. He threw it quickly and.
And they all jumped, and I think the captain.
I think he bit the big one.
He died.
It's okay. He was another scumbag. He deserved it, Scotty. Dead. Done.
Yep. And I think that's it, right?
That's how it ended. We don't know if they survived with the big explosion, and that was kind of faded to black. And that was the end of episode number 7.
Well, good episode.
Okay. Wasn't it phenomenal?
It was like another good episode. Yeah, some people we talked to, I don't know about you, they're saying that it's not as good as the other season. As I'm referring to season 1 and 2.
If you said that, you are not a fan.
Yeah, you know who you are.
That's right.
Because you watch our show.
That's right.
So I know who you are. I'm not going to call you out, though.
Who is this, Scott? You're going to tell me. Tell me off when we get off.
I'll tell you off camera.
Okay, because I want to... address the situation.
So if you guys like this review breakdown, hit a like, share, subscribe.
Yep.
We did our Transformers International trailer
reaction.
You should see us. We weren't too happy about what we saw.
It was still good. Don't get us wrong.
It was still good.
Over surprised, and yeah, we were a little disappointed because they kind of ruined a little bit of a surprise for us. That's
so
all.
It will. The video will be linked at the end of the video.
Yes.
And those little end caps.
And then what's later on today, Scotty?
Or tomorrow.
Tomorrow. Sorry. I apologize, Scotty.
Tomorrow we're gonna do episode 38.
Yes.
What's coming out in the box office?
Yep.
And also 39. What happened with all the TV shows this week?
What went down in the week of entertainment and movies, guys? We're gonna take care of it, Scotty.
Whatever is worth talking about for us, anyways.
Yes, that you guys will enjoy.
Yeah. All right, guys. Be good. See you soon.